Hi everyone, I'm Jaap H for Film Impact. Today I'm going to be showing you how to apply video transitions in Premiere Pro. I'll be talking about transition timing and transition length, some of the issues you may encounter when applying video transitions, and then I'm going to show you how to tweak and modify video transitions, and I'll be comparing some of the free tools that Film Impact offers versus the built-in video transitions that automatically come with Premiere Pro itself. Let's get started. I'm in the effects workspace, which is optimized for adjusting and adding effects and video transitions. And here are the effects library. And when opening the video transition section, it's going to show you a list of all the video transitions that you've got installed. Now I have two clips here. So a driving car. And let's apply the most commonly used video transitions, which is the cross dissolve. And applying video transitions is just drag and drop and place it onto the cut. And there you go, playing it back, which performs a beautiful fade from one clip to another, right? And by default, this video transition is a 1 second duration. If you want this transition to be shorter or longer, just click the transition and drag the handles here. Now I'm going to lengthen, give it more time to breathe, or shorten it. There you go. And another way to change the length of this video transition is simply by double clicking it. Double clicking it will set the transition duration. And here it has the format of hours, minutes, seconds, and frames. If you want to have a 2 second video transition, just enter 200, enter, or hit OK. And there you go, you have a 2 second video transition. Now I'm going to show you a common issue that may arise when you have made the video transition too long. Just double clicking it, and for this example I'm going to hit a 3 second video transition. And now you can see diagonal lines here. And what does this say? This should concern you, because this indicates repeated frames. Check out the car here. And now I'm going to move it through time, and now the car has stopped because there's no more media. And let's visually indicate there's no more media. I'm just going to duplicate the clips here. Alt drag, and I'm going to try and make this video transition as long as possible. And as you can see, it stops here. There's no more media beyond that point, beyond this particular point. And I'm going to do the same for this clip. And when you look at this, this is showing you the interesting part, because the transition needs overlap between this clip and that clip. And as you can see, beyond the overlapping points here and here, there's going to be repeated frames. And having repeated frames will stop the flow of the video transitions. This is kind of a hiccup. It doesn't feel right. So try and prevent having repeated frames. Just lowering the length of the video transition. And there you go. So this is how you apply video transition in Premiere Pro. And another cool timing feature is just you can drag and move the transition from the center just to the left or to the right. And when you feel like you're hitting a limit, for example, I cannot move the transition any further to the right here. And that is because this clip doesn't have enough media. So sometimes Premiere will even show a dialogue. And when applying video transitions, insufficient media. This transition will contain repeated frames because, hey, this clip has no more media. It's just hitting the end of this clip. And so this is where Premiere shows a dialogue. But again, this has to do with insufficient frames. If you want more details on this particular issue, we have a separate video on insufficient media, check out the description below. Now let's talk about tweaking and modifying video transitions. And what I'm going to do is click the transition and head over to the effects controls tab. On this point, this is practically empty because the built-in cross dissolve doesn't have many options to play with. And you might think to yourself, what would be options that you want to play with a cross dissolve? Well, let's show you a free tool that we've got for you. It's sitting in the Film Impact Essentials tools, tools you can download on our website, filmimpact.com. And I'm going to apply the dissolve impacts just as easy, drag and drop. And there you go. Now clicking this particular transition will show you options here. And what are the options? This curve graph indicates how the fade will move from clip A to clip B. And it can be very, very subtle on the starting of the fade. And you can precisely tweak this fade, and let's give it more time to breathe, and this will create the ultimate smooth video transition. Another cool tool we have is the push, and let's search the effects browser for push, for the push effect, and the built-in push is sitting under the slide section. Just drag and drop, and by default forms a push. When I click the transition, I can set some of the parameters here, and the most interesting here is the direction. So I can make the push happening from top to bottom or from right to left. There you go. But besides some bordering options here, there are not many options you can play with. Let's compare this with the push impact, which is another free tool by Film Impact, and applying is as easy as drag and drop. So drag, drop, it's the same for the built-in transitions. And there you go. This is the push that comes with the free Film Impact package. And when clicking the effect and going to the effects controls tab, you'll find again the curve section, which indicates how smooth this video transition is. And you can add some chromatic aberration, add some extra blur, even add some stretch if you want. So this video transitions has a lot more options there, and see how that works on your video. Perfect. So this is how to apply video transitions in Premiere Pro. I would recommend trying 30 days of free access to all of the Film Impact video transitions. I hope you like this video. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.